Okay, the next thing I want to do are the belts around the feet over here and on the arms. And the process is the similar, it's very similar to what we've been doing on the other belt bits. Very simple. Let's go ahead and get started. First thing we want to do is, of course, we're going to find the areas that include that. And first area, I think, will be arms. Let's start with the arms. This will be nice and easy. So the arms are right here. Obviously, we're going to need a little bit of a just some leather texture there, or leather normals. I'm going to go down here and grab some. See if we can find it, wherever that may be. Okay, I think this one's a good place to start. Let's start with this. Just going to grab a small piece. And you can hardly see it, I know. But that is the piece that I'm talking about. Let's go ahead and rotate it around like that. One thing you also want to keep in mind, it's probably not a good idea to rotate those pieces around, as I just remembered. If you rotate it around, you're actually losing some of that some of that information, or you're screwing with the information of the normal map. So let's try not to rotate it. I kind of already did in previous respects, so whatever, that's okay. All right, one thing I do want to do, however, is shrink this down to something like that. I think it's a good place to start. Of course, let's just duplicate it across. That'll be our first belt. Let's copy and paste it up here. Transform like that. Just make sure you work within the boundary of that UV map, as close as you can. Okay, that's good. Let's grab the bottom one again and move it up here. Very simple process. Shouldn't be too complicated to do this. Can see it's really just all about using the tools that you have at hand and going from there. And of course, you can go ahead and sculpt it out, but we're not going to do that. We're not that crazy. Unless we want to be. Alright, so overlay is looking good. I'm going to use just a blur, Gaussian blur. So let's blur it out slightly and just reduce the opacity. Great. Another thing I do want to do, of course, is I want to try and just close off some of these other little pieces. Let me just double check. So zoom all the way out. I'm going to turn this to difference. Okay, cool. So I've got the belt. There we go. What I want to do, however, is just lock off everything else. So let's leave it as it is, actually. I'll just merge it with the turtleneck. Whoops. That's not what I wanted to do. So turtleneck 100%. Merge that. Actually, no, I probably shouldn't do that. All right, I'll leave it as it is. But that's basically the belt left. I have to rename these a little bit later. All right, back to the belt here, or the arm belts. Unbelievable. What am I doing? It's gonna get really tricky to zoom in and out all the time. That's all right. So the belts over here, let's go to our Endo2 folder. So just collapse that. And we'll go to arm belt. I'm going to create a new layer. So arm strap. We'll just call it strap since it's nice and easy to remember. And of course, we'll need to bring up Endo2 again. So let's start that up. Same workflow. Nothing much has changed here. So this time I might want to zoom in a little bit closer. So we start with the pen tool. Zoom in all the way there, like that. Let's make this one. Since, by the way, it's very small. And whoops, I forgot again. Gotta convert it. And then we can sculpt. Okay, go ahead, sculpt. Pen tool, hold shift, and just create that little square, that little rectangle. Turn this to 1. Of course, want to zoom in and see the result. That's not bad, actually. Pretty good for a first try. Great. So with that done, rasterize the layer. I'm just going to simply copy and paste it on the rest of them. So copy and paste like that. 1, 2, 3. I don't think I'm going to bother with any new ornaments. I think I'll just leave it as it is. Let's make sure it's at the edge, as close to the edge as we can, and that's looking pretty good. I think I'm missing one again. And I've misclicked. So select that. And copy and paste. Great, that belt's pretty much done. I think we can leave it here. And of course, I also want to grab the stitch color. So let's copy, shift paste, and then collapse the normal. So this will be the map, arm strap. This will be arm strap map. Very good. Select that, invert my selection, and delete the rest of my normal map. And there we have it. Even though it's very small, at least it looks pretty good. I might undo that for a second, because I believe I forgot to get out of sculpt mode. Which I'm sure I did. Yep, I forgot to get out of sculpt mode. Let's try that again. That's looking better. Alright, so we just collapse the normals. And there we go. Looks great. Even though it's subtle, it looks really good. Might turn the opacity down to 40%, something like that. Arm strap. And this is arm strap map. Excellent. All right, what else do we have? Let's move on down to the feet here. You can see I've taken out the feet straps or the belts over there. So we have it right here. Let's go to the feet. Span the... This is actually the feet belt. Feet belt. I want to rename this carefully because we've got so many layers now that it's very hard to keep track. That's why you want to always rename your stuff whenever you can. I know I've been breaking my rules here every now and then, but that's alright. I'll just leave it as an empty and convert it to a brand new normal map. And very simple, same deal as before, except I might make a small change. Let's grab the pen. And instead, I'm just going to go all the way to the end, like that. Put it down to 2. I think 2 is a nice number. Looks really good. And of course, I forgot again. Forgot to go into sculpt mode. So go to sculpt mode. There we go. That's frustrating. All right, let's go ahead and paint that in again. Very quick. Leave it at 2. Quick review. Looks good. Excellent. With that done, let's go ahead and marquee select. Hold Alt, drag it down, and we're just simply copying it over the rest of those belt segments here as well. This one might need to move it a bit forward. There we go. So what Endo 2 is doing, it's taking the values that you've painted in and turning it into a normal map, okay? Which is really useful. All right, and that's looking good. That's the stitches for that. What I'm going to do is get out of sculpt mode. That way we'll get that those nice little values there. Let's go to my edge brush. I'm going to copy the map again because I need it. And then finalize the normals. Also select, marquee select the normals, invert and delete the outside. So we only have the interior. You can clean up the rest if you want. I'm going to leave it like that for the moment. Let's call this feet strap. This will be feet strap map. It's So that's finished. I'm going to create another one because I want to add some buttons to each of these belt segments. So again, convert. Let's go to my marquee tool, elliptical tool. And I might create, whoops. Ah, dear. That's a bit weird. All right, and then we'll just paint it in that color. Might create another one, just a smaller one, or maybe a couple. Again, same thing, like that. And again, I just want to keep it in threes. So for this one, I might move it up here. Move that one up there. Let's try again and transform. So I just want to flip it to the other side, like that. Right, and move it here. And again, on this one. Just very carefully placing it in there. That's looking good. Let's do the same on the bottom. Should probably use a rectangular one, but it's all right. And we flip. And this is coming from a mental library in my head when I'm trying to sculpt out. These buttons are something that I just want to add in because I feel it adds a little bit of personality. For the bottom parts of the belt, I'm going to try just one big button to break apart that linearity. Remember, I don't want to clone this. Ah, come on. I don't want to clone this at all. Just want to make it work for the audience, so we'll probably keep it as one and then one small one. Maybe on this side, like that. Okay, that might indicate this is a slightly different buckle. Most buckles work the same way anyway. I might delete a few. All right, we'll go here. Flip. So, whoops. So we'll go ahead and flip. W minus, so minus 100% to flip it. Same on the bottom. Minus 100 to flip. Throughout this process, while I'm creating this, I'm always thinking about the end result. Okay, which is basically this character. So we're definitely not just blindly doing things. We want to always have the end result in our brains. It's like going on a trip. If you're going on a road trip, you want to have the end destination just in the middle of your mind so that you at least, you can take different directions or shortcuts to get there. Many people take maybe a different highway or something, but the destination is where we're aiming for. Same here. So how you do this is up to you. If you want to use a sculpting tool, you are certainly welcome to do that. But I'm going to use this. Let's change the depth, and I might also change the fall off. The fall off is a little bit too low. Increase the fall off to maybe 100%. So anti-aliasing, not too much, just a little bit. Change the depth again. There we go. So nice and subtle. Don't want it to be too deep. With that done, let's go ahead and copy. Same deal. I want that map. I don't want to lose it. And then I can commit to the normal. So this will be the we'll call it the nails or buckles, badges. I'm just gonna call it badges. I don't really know what it's called. Map. Actually, I do know what it's called, but I can't remember. My brain is just not working in that mode at this stage. So with that, let's go ahead and delete the rest of the normal map, just the outside part. Because I do want this to be a separate segment. And what else can we add here? Well, it's up to you. Might reduce the stitches, of course. I might actually create another layer underneath the badges and give it a slight indentation. So same deal as before, we're going to use the sculpt tool. And this time I'm going to make the slant down. Okay. From here, it's very simple. We just go ahead and paint that value in. So that value is what we have there. So that might give us some interesting results. And I'm doing it by hand, of course. Now you can do it for the rest of your objects, but I'm not going to bother. It's up to you though. Completely up to you if you want to do that. Go ahead and add this. Just gives that really good realism. Same deal here, like that. Just punch it in. Just punch that in like that. I think the result is pretty good so far. Whoops. Shrink my brush. Pretty happy with it. Can't wait to see how it turns out once we get into Dido, that's for sure. And you guys, if you haven't used Dido yet, you're gonna love it, believe me. And I know I've said this many times, but I kid you not, you really are going to love it. All right, I'm gonna commit to that, so let's bring it out of Sculpt. Make sure you have Edge Mode selected. Turn off Sculpt. Let Ender 2 finalize that for you, and then just finish up. So I'll call it Dent. And as always, I want to use an overlay for that, like that. That indentation is looking good. Excellent. With that done, let's preview this back in Maya again. Just double checking to see if there's anything I can add here. Before I go, I might add one more. So, well, let's create another folder. We'll call it Boot. I know there's technically no boot there, but I do want to create some, a little bit of seaming over there. All right, and let's start. We'll turn the slant down. I'm going to start sculpting this out. So that's a down slant. And what I'm going to do is put it down the middle right there. And that might not make any sense. That's okay. Down the middle like that. Yeah, I think everything is okay. Let's just go ahead and finalize it. So get out of sculpt mode. See what we get. Something like that. It's not bad. Change the softness maybe to 2. Very, very harsh right now. That's pretty good. And I might go ahead and... Actually, I'll just leave that out. Let's not bother with that. We'll commit to that. Turn this to overlay. One thing I might do, however, is just select these areas. So shift, select them. Control-I. Control-Shift-I, my apologies. And even though it technically looks like this, so these two flat areas. I've just deleted the rest because just in case I have other values. It's just to tidy it up. All right, looking great. Let's go back into Maya. Well, first we have to export this. Let's export this and then go back to Maya and see what we have. And back in Maya, well, we all know how to do this now. We'll go to our Hypershade and reload this. Very annoying that you have to do it manually, but anyway, it's no big deal. People tend to freak out when they don't have little conveniences like that, but no big deal. So that's the boot. And you can also see these buttons here holding onto the boot. So they kind of make sense. You've got this line, which will indicate the seam of where the boot is. So the belts are sort of pulling it together, and that's looking really nice. Some parts may need some extra help, but I think overall that's very readable. You can see the detail is pretty impressive. Alright, let's go and see what we've got on the arm belt. We're almost done, guys. Getting very close. And you can see it's very low detail. That's because we don't have enough resolution there. That's fine. I'm not worried about that. Because remember, that's just a very minor detail. But that's dependent upon your project, okay? Alright, looking good. I believe we've done all the small secondary items. We can have a play around with other aspects if you want. That's up to you. I don't believe I need to. I think we can begin the the next stage of this process, which will be the armor. And this is where we can get really creative. Okay, so I'll see you guys in the next video.